working on a KitchenAid side-by-side refrigerator today, and the original complaint was that the Yoder loop in front was getting warm. I'll show you that in a minute. That's an early warning sign that something's wrong with the condenser area. Either air's not moving, or the condenser's dirty, or something's going on back there in the condenser to make it heat up. I have another video on that here in my channel that explains exactly how all that works. I encourage you to search for it and look for it. But here, I came back to the back, and this fan wasn't running. This is the condenser fan back here. This is the condenser fan motor, the blade. And real commonly, the motor itself is just burned out. However, I always check the voltage going to the fan to make sure it's got proper power supply, which you can do. There's the red-white wire here, and the white is the neutral. So you got hot. It's an AC motor, not a DC motor, even though it looks like it would be a DC motor. But you come back here to this connector, and you can go into, you can put your probes right in here in the red, white, and the white here, and measure between here, and I was getting zero, basically 0 volts. The main control board is what supplies the voltage to that fan. The main control board is here. This is the inverter control board for the compressor. There's an inverter compressor. It's a separate control board that it's behind this metal shield here that controls a lot of the other functions in this box. The problem here is this board is no longer available. It can only be rebuilt. So what I'm going to do, since that seems to be the only function that's missing in the board, is supplying the voltage to the condenser fan motor, what I'm going to do is hot wire the condenser fan motor. I'm going to steal 120 volts from the incoming, here's the power cord here, this black wire jumps off of the hot wire, and I'm going to steal 120 volts off this wire and supply it to the condenser fan motor here. All right, I'm going to go around front and show you the Yoder loop so you get an idea of the original complaint. So here's the front of the unit, and the Yoder runs around the mullion, and they were feeling it very warm here. And it's just a loop of the sealed system that runs through here. It does a couple things. It helps to get rid of some of the heat, and also keeps this nice and warm so moisture doesn't build up on here, so that your gaskets stay nice and clean and pliable. And these gaskets are actually in good shape. So that's the Yoder loop. Okay, and here is my artwork. I spliced in, here's my red-white wire that goes through this harness back over to the condenser fan, which is now running. You can see that. And then, so here all I've done is just tap into this black wire that was going and supplying power to the control board anyway. I've not interrupted it, I've just tapped into it, and now I'm supplying the voltage that was missing. The only difference now, so we've restored the function of the condenser fan motor, and which was making the Yoder loop warm up, and that's what prompted the customer to call me, early warning sign. The only difference now is this condenser fan motor is going to run all the time versus the way it was before, where it's only supposed to run when the compressor runs, and the compressor is running right now. So, not a big deal. It's a low current draw motor. They won't even notice the change in their power bill. More importantly, the refrigerator will function normally now. Yoder loop will cool down. They're going to preserve the compressor because it was running operating at a very high temperature and pressure before. It's still very hot, but it's cooling down. It's very hot to the touch. You can't even keep your hand on it. It was so hot. So, problem solved. Function restored.